This is Asim, a volunteer for Rossendale Futures.
Right, my name's Asim Eli. I'm 39 years old, getting on a bit now. And I live with my dad and my wife in Rossendale. I volunteer with Active Lancashire.
Yeah.
Really enjoy it.
And on the Active Lancashire side, you volunteer with us, don't you, on Rossendale Futures?
Yeah, on Rossendale Futures, yes. Yeah,
yeah, that's it. And Rossendale Works. Now, this will be a bit different at the moment because of COVID-19.
Yeah.
Before, where was you? You came to quite a few sessions, didn't you?
Yeah, before on average about three, four times a week, used to go to like the Trinity Church in Bakewell. We would do like a coffee morning, play table tennis and meet, look after some other people coming, which make them take coffee and talk to them, make them feel comfortable. It's really enjoyable, and then obviously
you tried a bit of art as well, didn't you, and a bit of table tennis.
Yeah, it's not my thing, but you know, I just like getting involved and like the community spirit. It's really, really enjoyable. I also do 1 day at the community link in Haslinden as well. It's like a coffee morning where we play badminton with another colleague called Hussein.
Yeah.
And it's really good because I like the sports side of it. I like meeting people, talking to people. So it suits me. I really, really enjoy it. That's what honestly, if I can make someone smile and make someone happy, it makes me day, and that's. It's a great job satisfaction. And then also go to Accrington, New Era in Accrington, to also help with another colleague called John, where we do like football, table tennis, and pool, and obviously communicate with some of the youngsters in the community that come along to talk to them and make them feel welcome.
Was it difficult to become a volunteer?
No, it wasn't really, because I initially started going as one of the clients and got to the spot. And then Hussein saw, when I said stuff with that Hussein, he probably saw that I was good with people helping him, and then he just suggested it and I was interested. And it just went ahead straight. It was straightforward, there's no...
Straightforward.
It wasn't really difficult.
Do you feel like you've had any barriers? Like you've had to overcome while...
Because of my dyslexia, I do have issues, but I don't see it as issues. Because if I feel formed in folk with new clients, then with my dyslexia, my reading, it can be an issue. But obviously, I have techniques to get around that. If I need them to print the forms in writing, then I'll get them to ask them to print them so I can read it better.
Yeah.
So I have different techniques to get around that. So to me, it's not an issue. I mean, some people would say it is, but for me, it's not.
So have you learned anything through volunteering? Is it like your communication skills, any self-belief, confidence?
Yeah, I mean, I lost my job and then I did just stuff at the library, but then obviously because I did it for so long, it wasn't varied. This is a lot more interesting. So, and it's just getting the confidence back up really after losing it, after not working for so long. And I knew I could do it, but then you doubt yourself sometimes, but it's really got my confidence back up again. For me, it's like, because I can't stay at home, it gets on my nerves, so it gives me structure that I've got to go and do this, and people are relying on me to get to certain places at certain times. So it gets me used to sticking to time, to deadlines, and just because people are relying on me, so I've got to make sure they're getting them on time. And the structure is the main thing, really.
Yeah, and I think it's assisted because we work with lots of different types of people from different cuts of cloth, don't we?
Yeah.
It's enabling yourself to develop and how to communicate with different people on many different levels, isn't it, as well? Would you recommend volunteering to others?
Definitely, I think, because mentally it can help, because if you're not waking up early every day or staying in bed for too long and not nowhere to go, it's not a structure, and it's like mental. It can suffer. Mental health can really affect you if you're not got structure and you're not. That's why I definitely would recommend it at the moment, especially. It's quite a big thing at the moment with mental health, and I think it could really help certain people.
I was asking what other courses would you like to do, because you offered some more courses. But that's a good one. That multi skills one.
What's that? Is that quite varied then?
Yeah, it's how to like set up your own session, you know, to like teach people the fundamentals of, let's say, playing tennis or something, the racket sport.
Well, that'd be good for the role that I do. That'll probably be a good one. And that behaviour change.
Yeah, behaviour change, that's another good one.
That could be good for the type of role that I do, I think. That could be a good one.